All right, I'm Trevor O'Toole from Barista Underground, and this one we have to see. This guy's got a...
Is over?
It looks to be like a surgical pillow and a drip. So this should be an interesting one, and I have to film this one. So this is for the Barista Underground website and for all our viewers to enjoy. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, in a few moments, Bruce Manning from Gauteng is going to present his demonstration in his attempt to win the South African National Barista Championship title here at the Good Food and Wine Show. Microphone working there, Bruce? Bruce, can you just mic check?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Good.
1, 2, 3, 4.
In a moment, I'm going to introduce the judges to you. Judges, stand by. If you can come forward, please. Judges for this round. Sensory judges, George Karatsis, Cuth Bland, Karen Moerdijk, and Bilbo Steyn. If we can have those sensory judges on stage, please. Ladies and gentlemen, those are the sensory judges. They stand on the opposite side of the bar to Bruce, the barista. They will be judging. The technical judges, Zane Madison, Neil Marie, head judge, Alessandro Morico. Please welcome the judges and Bruce Manning to the stage, ladies and gentlemen. Big round of applause, please.
Hello, hello. That's great. Thank you.
So, Bruce, when you're ready, you know how this works.
That's great.
You'll raise your hand to start the clock. You have 15 minutes, and you must raise your hand and say time to stop the clock, Bruce.
Okay.
So, when you're ready, we're in your hands.
Time. Greetings, judges. How's it going? I'm the coffee doctor, Bruce. I'll be giving you a medication today. I didn't put my apron on first. I just want to create an impression with the white shirt. Now we can get down to doing the job. So I had a lot of fun doing the whole medical theme. I'm a bit of a health nut, and I thought, let's look for the value in coffee. So today, think of the coffee shots that I'm giving you as your vaccinations, your immunity to Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, sugar diabetes, gallstones, even cancer. So at the bottom of the hospital bed is the patient file with a description on health benefits. Right, now many years ago I lived in Spain, I fell in love with coffee, I experienced cortado. Cortado is a very short shot of coffee, splash of milk on top. And I fell in love. Years later, I come to Tribeca, and I have the same coffee experience, and there's an East African bias. So I've done a Kilimanjaro Ethiopia blend. And when we speak in metaphor, we tend to internalize, or it resonates more clearly with us. So think of, while we're playing doctors and nurses, Dr. Kilimanjaro, sweet, mature, old school. He's the sucrose sugar, molasses. He's home-baked raisin bread. He's creamy. And Nurse Sadamo is from not as volcanically rich soils. Soil's a little bit lighter, she's more zesty, but not excessively citric. So the kiwi is going to represent that more tart characteristic. So the combination of these two should be a sufficiently zesty, but a full-bodied, rich, rewarding coffee experience. So I'm gonna pull your espressos now. And Ian, if I have time, I'll make two for you as well. Sorry, Alessandro. little exercise for the judges. Underneath the patient file, if you lift up both the file and the block of wood, you will see a range of colors, which I thought the espressos might represent in color terms. And of all those, they're not there. This is the trump card, and I can be pretty sure that if you hold this against the dark crema on the side, the base color, and the flaking, I'm sure I'm pretty spot on there. So for those who are interested, I'm going to put my sous vide, a fruit preparation, into the vacuum. In the meantime, while I draw the cappuccinos, the fruits pretty much represent the balance of the sweetness that we're going to pick up in the signature drink. So for those who are interested, come and have a look. This vacuum is something phenomenal. Time check, please, Ian.
10:23, Bruce. Minutes now.
Thank you. Right, there's a theme which is attached to the vacuum process, and that is oxidation. By removing oxygen, you inhibit bacteria development, but you also preserve. So the oxidation, if you noticed, the espressos are served cold. Heat will oxidize. The handles I've not got sitting in the head. This also tends to overheat and oxidize. Right, now my sous vide preparation is going to sit in hot water, and that's the effect of creating a compote. I would have to stew for 15 minutes, whereas the next few minutes, this process will already have the effect of stewing the fruit and removing the juice flavors. And I'm so sorry, you know, there's one habit I have. It's so intent on talking, I never pour the water. And I think I have a much drier mouth than yourselves.
Go, Bruce!
So, if anything, I was hoping that the Sodamo, no, Sodamo revealed herself more adequately than espresso, and the cappuccinos, I'd like to see more of the deep, fruity, plummy, sugary characteristics revealing themselves in the cappuccino. And then just a heads up, on the cappuccino, once they serve, judges, please take the teaspoon and fold the foam three times. Just blend in the crema with the foam. Change of plan. I was going to do four cappuccinos at once. Time check, please.
6 minutes, 45 seconds remaining.
Good. please remember the instruction. A couple of turns. It'll blend the sweetness of the milk.
Minutes remaining.
Thank you.
It's a balance.
Sorry. So normally cups are kept on top of the machine. Again, I feel that that just has the effect of oxidizing. Please give me regular time checks, please, every minute.
3:37 remaining.
Go.
Minutes now.
Thank you. So back to the sous vide. Right. We've prepared a fruit juice, fruit compote out of this. Now, our taste transporters are salt, sugar, and fats. For this reason, I've put avocado, fruits, and a drip. And this is just a regular saline drip of salt. A little bit in there. And that will help open up the flavors. So we open up the juice into our mixture.
2 minutes.
Okay. And we'll use my syringe to draw off.
At least I'm not using any needles. Main
artist. Give me a 30-second countdown, please.
One minute 30 now.
Come on, Brett. Thanks for the support. Appreciate it, all the Tribeca guys.
1 minute.
Thank you. All right, let's just draw some juice up here into my syringe. time check, please.
36 seconds.
Thank you.
30 okay, so seconds.
All those fruity characteristics I told you about from Kilimanjaro, Ethiopia, is going to be a blend of both the zesty. I'm going to give you about 10 mils of each. And this is going to highlight all those characteristics with a sweet compote effect. Just give it a little swirl. Time check, please.
3 seconds, 2, 1. Over time now.
Time.
Time, ladies and gentlemen. Bruce Manning from Gauteng. Congratulations, Bruce. Come and have a chat to me over here.
Thank you.
Well, we expected a performance, and the performance you gave.
I just, like I told you last time, it should be 20 minutes and we go into a lot more detail. I've got so much to talk about.
I think if you went into any more detail, you'd lose the audience.
Yeah, no, somebody said, Bruce, we'll give you 25 minutes, you'll go over by 1 minute 26. We'll give you 30 minutes, you'll go over 31. So we ought to put a limit somewhere.
Performance aside, let's talk about the coffee that you used here.
Ethiopia and Kilimanjaro seems to be the perfect blend. If you're excessively light and zesty, you don't deliver. And patrons, anybody can tell you, they want a rich, rewarding cup of coffee. So single origin's a bit of a risk, or on lightness. And we want something to cut through the milk. And I had a feeling that the Kilimanjaro, a bit like a Brazil, has a lot of sweetness, a lot of depth, body. But you need some zest, just a little bit of acidity on the palate. And you can't get excessively. So this particular blend, when I said we're playing doctors and nurses, the doctor was the mature, and I didn't specify percentages, but he's in the 60s, and she's in the 30s. So that was the analogy. I hope it resonated.
Are you happy? Are you happy with the performance, Bruce?
Yes, I'm delighted, actually. I would have liked to have done two other special things, but get to do the basics first. I think I've covered it all.
Well, your first time at the Nationals, Bruce, well done. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. Bruce Manning.
Thank you. And I'm sorry, if I had time, I would have liked to bring you some shots as well. I don't know if it's frowned upon, but I think you've got to look after the MC as well.
You can do one for me now.
Okay.
Thank you, judges. Go and confer. Score.
Oh, cheers. Thank you.
Put your hands together and score Bruce Manning. Let's see if that was enough to win him a title. So ladies and gentlemen, stick around because about half an hour we'll be having our second to last performance of the day.